Bangtan is still rising. Now it's time to reflect. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Landon and we are here again today for another Rise of Bangtan episode. Before we get started, I just want to say thank you so much to the army once again that have been compiling this series. It has been such a fun watch and truly needs to be recommended to people wanting to know how this started, what's it like in the world of K-pop, etc., etc. I love the blend of BTS information alongside the current cultural norms at the time. Really paints an amazing picture of the struggle, the rise, the ups, the downs that the boys went through. So today we're going to be watching episode number 4, and I'm ready. We will not be watching the deleted scenes and bonus content. We're saving those for another video in the future when we get a couple more under our belt. So thank you guys so much. If you want more of this, make sure you click subscribe and let's get started. Penelope's here. Yo. Is this the teaser? I don't know if I've seen that version. Maybe I have. It's been a minute since I watched that one. But we all know the controversy.
한 장씩 넘기면서 큰 소리로 읽어주세요. 젠몬스터 완전 아이돌 얼굴 아닌 방탄소년단에서 랩하는데 못생긴 아이돌로 데뷔했다는 건 래퍼를 포기한 거 아닌가? 이 노래를 힙합이라고 할 수 있나?
On TV? What are we doing here?
방탄소년단 랩 가사? 그것도 가사야. 증명하겠습니다.
Bruh. That just gave me so many chills already. God damn, imagine like going on Jimmy Fallon or something like that and reading that little, whoever does that, the little tweet section, and all the tweets are like, you suck, don't rap, you're horrible, retire, I hate you, blah, blah, blah. And you're up there and you're like, well, I'm here to prove it. Like, no, I would quit. Honestly, thank God they are so strong and have such tough skin. I don't know if I would have did it. I don't know if I could have made it. Yes. Damn, now I'm telling you a story. I like that change in the lyrics. I saw it. What's up? Okay, high school performing arts. Seoul. It's uniform nice. Is this graduation? Entrance ceremony, that's it. Isn't that crazy? They don't get homeschooled or nothing. Look at the little shirt. That's exactly what I've been wearing at that time. Books, dummy. What else would it be?
안녕하세요.
Don't be nervous. Look. What is that face, bro? Okay. He won't talk to them. Y'all are my friends. Look at that smile. You're such a big boy. Yep, that sucks. No, the feeling. Girl, same.
되게 어렸을 때부터 이제 성인에 대해서 생각을 많이 했었었다. 뭐 성인이 되면 이제
Nothing
이제
changes.
풀리게 되는 제한들이 생길 것이고, 되게 성인이 된 1월 1일 아침 똑같은 일상, 똑같은 숙소에 똑같은 멤버에 똑같은 일상에 똑같은 스케줄 형들, 이제 남준형이라든지 이제 호병이라든지 한살 차이밖에 안 나는데, 되게 뭔가 생각의 깊이가 너무 차이가 크다고 생각했었는데,
참 2014년에 더 내가 나를 더 많이 보여주고 내가 어느 정도의 끝까지 올라갈 수 있는지, 방탄소년단이 어느 레벨까지 올라갈 수 있는지 한번 꼭
Thank
시험해보고
God,
싶다.
such a good leader on your hands there, buddy.
재밌을
God
것
damn.
같다.
good for
많이
you.
뭐 정말 이제 꼭 컴백을 앞두고 있고, 아미들도 이제 저희를 보실 걸 기다리는 일만 남았거든요. 정말 그래서 이렇게 또 올해 저희 정말 쉴틈 없이 정말 바쁘게 아미들과 같이 활동을 할 거니까 올해도 항상 행복하시고 건강하셨으면 좋겠습니다.
건강하세요. 저희 정말 야심차게
새해 복
준비했습니다.
많이 받으세요.
같이 해볼게.
Y'all do choreography or no? Okay. That's my favorite like choreography you do when you go like this. 하쿠나 마타타 Imagine like going to school and then like and then all of a sudden you go back and you watch your TV show and stuff and one of your little friends is doing this on stage. It's crazy to me. I feel like just in America here, it's if you're a part of that life, you're not gonna be a part of a regular school life kind of thing. So that's what's always kind of not thrown me off, but it's just been so intriguing to me that they still go through school normally. I always thought about that. I'm like, damn, this boy, imagine trying to learn calculus and then having to go learn choreography. Calculus, choreography, calculus, choreography. It's like it's too much. It's a lot. Is this with all the cockroaches and the ghosts?
진짜 저희 지금 한 달 넘게 너무 눈 뜨면 안무, 눈 뜨면 안무였습니다. 설날 때도요.
Look at the positive attitude, though, still. You could tell that they want this.
확실히 답답할 것 같긴 해요. 저라면 못했을 거예요.
남준이랑은 예전에 방탄소년단 연습생하고 같이 했었지만 전 안 했죠. 좀 안 맞았어요.
How do you feel
어디를
now?
가도 허락을 맡아야 되고 그냥 통제죠. 싹다 통제. 모든 게 통제돼 있으니까 뭐
That makes sense.
그렇죠. 답답한 때도 있고.
There's one man who's done more than almost anybody else to shape K-pop, Suman Lee of SM Entertainment.
미국 유학을 가서 그러면서 그럼 그때
MTV.
Oh, about to say not with BTS.
초점을 okay, 두고 yeah. 해외를 나가야 되겠다라고 생각을 하면서 엔터테인먼트 사업을 시작했었습니다.
Soo-man Lee's global ambition didn't get off to the best of starts. His first signing, former dancer Hyunjin Young, went to prison for drugs possession.
Because we consider them as idols, we don't allow any speck of dust on them. So we don't just stop at saying drugs is bad. Don't do it. We don't do that. We say you are out of this industry. You shall forever be banned from the stage.
The scandal was a valuable lesson for Soo-man Lee, who realized that to be successful, his artists would not only need to be incredible performers, they'd also have to be impeccably behaved.
And that's where it all started.
And so he began developing a system for training raw talent.
And this is why I think we have this perception here that they go through this rigorous training world and they have to be created like robots and stuff like that. It's because this one man was like, we're not having none of that in this industry that we're building right over here, which is wild. I had no idea about the dude that had drug possession. I'm like, okay, girl. Wild. You couldn't do that to an American artist because then every American artist would be dropped, essentially.
The system ended up being a great success and every major South Korean managerial company did this day follows it.
This is only from my experiences, but managements could always check your phone at any time that they want. No junk food, no going out.
They have terms like no dating, dieting, some even have like plastic surgery.
I remember that I was too dark, like my skin was too tan and I had to brighten my skin. I know that there's a standard, I know that there is this goal that we're all trying to achieve. And you know, being in an industry where it's so visually focused, you know, you're gonna go through the checklist of, okay, is your hair on point? Is your face on point? Is what you're wearing good?
I agree.
That's how I feel too. But then again, a lot of people don't give them free access to be creative. I mean, I feel like I've been seeing and hearing a lot lately that that is the case now. Like a lot of groups are letting their members write lyrics and help produce and help choreograph and et cetera, et cetera. I'm just imagining, I don't know if this is right. This is just my opinion. And like the very beginnings of thing, everything was formulated, calculated perfectly. What you were going to wear, say exactly, even in interviews, was going to be heavily watched and manipulated by the company. I feel like we've grown lax over a while because this was, of course, before social media. Social media opens up the doors to a lot of things, whether it's good or bad, and it can kind of point a mirror at you in a weird way. Maybe that was a reason why, I don't know. But in my head, it feels like it's become a little bit more lax lately. Let me know.
You
will, yes. Yes.
Fighting. J-Hope, fighting. J-Hope, fighting. J-Hope, logo, good. 영감이 떠올리게.
Fighting. Fighting. Hongdae District.
내 남의구라고. 옛날에 같이 이제 음악 듣던 친구들이
This is gonna be good or bad.
아 그럼 우리도 그냥 그런 거 한번 해보자. 그때부터 이제 쭉 같이 공연도 하고.
대담협이 인터뷰 했었잖아요. 그분들 관해서 뭐라고 했을 것 같아요?
막 아이돌 됐다고 막 이렇게 할 것 같아요.
This is so nerve-wracking. What the fudge? I don't want to be here. I don't want to do this.
김남주는 방탄소년단이 됐네요.
아 근데
I don't want to do this.
이럴 수가. 근데 너 화장은 어떻게 나가?
나?
화장은 어떻게 나가? 개집애처럼.
개집애처럼.
하나면 저 믹스테이프에 안 껴줘서 제가.
I want to turn around. I can't watch. I don't want to watch this. This is so awkward. This is so awkward because like right now you don't know June, the people. You do know that you are impacting people's lives, but you have no idea that you are going to be speaking at the UN, you know, kind of thing. And I'm over here being so nervous for you to meet your little old friend rappers who making fun of your makeup. It's like, why don't you make fun of something else? Hello, I'm changing the world. Remember how you love yourself? Start with that and then start judging me. Wait. RM hasn't thought of this yet. I don't want to give me any ideas. I don't want to mess up any of the timeline. You know, I don't want to mess up history. So you didn't hear any of that, RM. I just want you to know I'm uncomfortable during this. I hate this. God, I'm not a confrontation type of person. And we're going to watch this again.
언더그라운드라는 것 자체가 굉장히 인디펜던트하고 자기 자주성을 가지고 하는 거잖아요. 근데 아이돌이라는 거는 회사의 기획과 그래서 자기가 하고 싶은 걸 사실 할 수 없어요. 왜냐면은 회사에서 봤을 때는 이거는 대중들이 원하는 게 아닌데 그러면은 이제 언더 매니아, 힙합 매니아라고 한 사람들은 그런 거를 당연히 안 좋게 보죠.
If you look at the three biggest types of music in Korea, it's indie music, hip-hop music, and R&B. A reason for that is people want to hear truth. Mm-hmm. Hip-hop isn't necessarily intimate, but a lot of Korean hip-hop music is actually truth to power. Koreans want lyrics and music that is emotional and captivating. We are going off the big, large generalization in the large sphere of things. Idols do not write their own lyrics. And idol music, the lyrics are largely shallow, and we can act like it's not, but it's not often that idol music has a lot of truth and power behind the lyrics. We, as K-pop fans, feel like it's unjust because they work so hard. What we are having trouble with being outside of the Korean context is it's derivative. Mm-hmm. To them, it's derivative. You can't get away with just a really good title track K-pop song. That's not how you build a fan base. That's not how you get loyalty. You use the title track to lure people in, to catch their attention.
And tell them your truth.
If your B-sides can't show off that your group is special and different somehow, you're not gonna survive.
That's it.
어떤 뮤지션들이나 자기가 음악을 결과물 내고 그거에 대해서 뭐 호평을 해주는 사람도 있는 거고 또 반면에 분명히 좋아하는 사람도 있을 거란 말이죠. 그 호평들을 받아들여서 다음 앨범을 그 사람들까지도 만족시킬 수 있는 앨범을 만드는 게 아티스트로서의 성장 아닌가 싶어요.
It's true.
힙합을 정말 사랑하는 음악 평론가 입장에서 이건 내가 공격받으면 하다라는 부분이 몇 가지 있었고 몇 가지는 이거는 편견이다. 좀 더 저희를 알아주시고 조금 더 저희의 히스토리라던가 그런 거를 아셨으면 그렇게까지는 안 쓰시지 않았을까 라는 생각을 드립니다.
Here we go, bitch.
데뷔하기 전에는 이미 언더그라운드에서 래퍼로 활동을 하셨더라고요. 몇 살 때부터 한 거예요?
14살 때부터 중2 때부터 활동을 했었는데 이제 네 그렇게 좀 어릴 때부터 힙합을 많이 좋아해서
This is what made them stand out, for real for me. Oh, that makes me so happy.
이런 실력을 가진 친구를 그냥 둘 수 없다.
추가군은 제작사 주최한 전국 배틀 오디션에서 2등.
I didn't sing it.
또 제이홉은 당시에 지역에서 춤을 잘 추는 걸로 정평이 나 있었던 친구. 예술고등학교에 수석 입학한 수재였습니다.
저는
방탄소년단이라는 아이들이 반짝반짝 빛나는 멋진 스타에서 한 걸음 더 나아가길 바랐습니다. 내가 어떻게 같이 가나 바랐어. 우리 싹 다 가라 아픈 모든 한판이 생각지 못한 바람 너덕 없이 한탄을 내면 막상고래 음악 한다 죽었는데 한판이 나도 알아봐라 널 찾고 가는 다른 거리어는 하나만 하겠지만 꼭 살아남아 꾸준히 축소가 아마니들 꼬리표는 아마 추억 같은 인생 너희를 보나 나봐라 이동시에 피해는 가는 뻔히 부모처럼 널 볼 때마다 맘 아파.
I wish I could just, this is what I want to just say to y'all. You know what? The rap line annoys me. And let me tell you why. They know good and well when they were writing this music that like 5 to 10 years later, there would be a game where I would have to play this with my fingers. Okay? Suga, Yoongi, Minyoongi, how dare you rap so fast when you know I gotta play this on Rhythm Hive? Okay? Not this one specifically, let's be honest. Not this one specifically, but there are a lot of times when I just wanna punch you in the face. How dare you be so effing talented that I can't pass level 40? You know? Sorry, I had to get that off my chest. Ooh, y'all can see that was a little emotional for me. Sorry about that. Let's keep going.
Yeah.
What you doing?
제 영상을 찍게 된 이유는 맨날 팬분들한테 받기만 해서.
Is this where he's online shopping?
Yeah.
Look at this. He's making little packs. I love it. I love this. You'll end up helping me. You will. This hard-ass underground rapper is wrapping up Kit Kats for you with love. JK, go to school.
형, 이거
제가 해준대 뭐
A lot. What does it say?
언제나 사랑할게.
햄나.
이거 좋다. 이거 완전 좋은데요? 이거 기분 좋아.
Don't lose weight.
아, 이거
오래진다. Here we go. This is the fan meet. Look at Suga. You're so awkward and I love it.
저희도 모르게 이런 걸 준비해가지고
몰랐어요.
몰랐죠. 그냥 가라했어요. 그래서
중요한 건 뭔지 아세요? 저한테 이런 거 준비 없어요. 너무 멋있는데.
He likes the fans more. It's R. I'm sorry. Okay, like, listen back to this real quick. Okay, BTS premieres. Today, this event was happening, and I went there. This 6-foot-tall man who doesn't speak the language with his beard looking, I guess, like Jesus. That's what y'all keep telling me. Standing on the crowd, and Suga's like, I got you, Kit Kat. And I just started screaming, Kyout! I would. But it's just funny for me to think about that now. Okay. Sorry, let's keep going. You did it.
주말에 했어야 되는데 심심한 슈가 한 대씩 때려주세요. 좋네요.
It did. Calm down. Now it's time for a nap. I've been too nice for the day.
새로 늦게까지 작업했어요, 레몬이. 뭐 레몬이는 뭐 일상이 작업이기 때문에.
왜 저 뛰었잖아, 레몬.
안녕하세요. 좋은 점도 되게 많고 그리고 사실 큰 무대에서 하는 게 쉽지가 않은데 흥미돼. 그리고 방송에서 나를 더 알릴 기회를 많이 얻었고요. 실제로 그거 덕분에 더 많은 사람들이 제 음악을, 제 목소리를 듣고 제 무대를 보고 있으니까.
제 생각하세요?
Great, I loved it.
제 생각을 제 음악으로 옮겨 담아서 그걸 사람들한테 들려준다. 아, 쟤네 음악도 안 하고 그냥 회사에서 시키는데 노래 말아서 춤이나 추는 것들이 무슨 가수냐, 이나 무슨 아티스트냐, 저런 애를 더 이상 나오면 안 된다.
빨리 가고 싶다, 집에. 엄마가 보고 싶다.
I can imagine how hard this is.
모두가 날 기다리고 있을 것이다.
아이돌.
Can call me
artist. 저는 되게 암담했어요. 아니, 암담할 때보다 되게 막막했어요. 이제 앞으로 저는 항상 하루에도 수백 번 수천 번 생각해요. 이걸 내가 가지고 있는 아티스트적인 능력을 어떻게 더 증명할 것인가 부터 시작해서. 그래서 저는 사실 제가 방탄소년단에 들어온 이유는 하나인데, 그냥 내 목소리 그냥 최대한 많은 사람한테 들려주는 거, 그게거든요.
이상한 잡생각이 많아면서
Stop, I know.
고생을 한다고 해야 되나? 집을 떠나서 산다기보다는 부모님과 같이 살고 싶다.
사실 저희만큼 정말 우리 힙합 하면서 슬로건을 걸고 나온 팀이 없는 것 같아요. 제가 그런 막 그 공격을 너무 많이 받고, 힙합을 사랑하는 분들, 뭐 저랑 옛날에 같이 음악을 하던 분들도 심지어 저를 욕하고,
리얼하게 살고 싶다고 항상 생각을 했는데, 뭔가 기분이 좋지 않은데 기분 좋은 척 해야 될 수도 있고.
아들, oh god, not this one. Stop, this is so bad. Don't make me watch this again.
컨택에서 활동하고 있는 두 번째 미니 앨범 열심히 활동해 그동안 고생한 바람 꼭 얻을 수 있도록 아빠를 기원할게. 그리고 무엇보다도 아빠가 바라는 것은 내 건강이야. 아들 사랑한다. 제이홉 파이팅. 감사합니다.
파이팅. I'm just saying this. I can't do this. This one always gets me.
울음이 나오는 거. 뭐 그냥 생각하기 나름인 것 같아. 뭔가를 보고 싶어하는 사람은 그 보고 싶은 것만 보고 그 보이지 않는 것은 안 보니까요. 그리고 아마 정말 관심 있고 아이돌이라는 것을 제대로 이해하려고 해봤다면 아마 그렇게 얘기하지 않을 것 같습니다. 저는 그렇게.
You're very correct. Let it go.
Whatever it is. 네.
네.
누가는 얘기 안. 정국.
예.
왔어.
2013년 5월 13일. 레몬스터.
안녕하세요.
레몬스터.
It's team. 하고,
that's it, boo. That's it.
인간들이 나였으면 좀 모르겠지만, 사실 인간이라면 누구나 그럴 수도 있겠지만, 내가 뭔가 더 갈망하지 않았나 이렇게 생각이 든다. 인생이 방황이라고 생각을 하기 때문에, 인생 방황이 연속이고, 사실 지금 더군다나 또 젊어서 많이 방황한 시기라고
생각이 Who you tell him, girl?
추억이네요. 제가 어렸을 때 테니스 선수였는데.
You go pick it back up, don't worry.
세 팀 중에.
소비 좀 한다.
Oh, I was about to say, oh my gosh, wait, is this me seeing Jimin actually playing basketball? I know I said it in a couple videos back. I was like, but when were you the basketball MVP? I'm just assuming it was always Suga, shooting guard, over here, that was. But you didn't help me prove it, Jimin, just now. Look at that face, too. Sorry, I'm just gonna take a little screenshot of this. Y'all know if you watch my run reactions, this happens a lot. Okay, continuing.
야, 음악을 만들 때 뭔가 더 오래 꽃 심을 수 있는 음악을 만들고 싶다는 생각을 한다. 처음에 꽃이고 처음에 다 알아줄 수 있는 그런 식으로 가사와 음악도 좋지만
들을수록
맛이 나고 아 이런 뜻이었구나. 내가 이런 의미로 이때 이렇게 썼었구나. 난 그런 음악을 또 만드는 게 나의 의무이고 좀 더 나의 오랜 팬들을 더 만들 수 있는 계기가 아닌가라고 생각을 한다.
여기는
beach?
Beach?
Beach? Beach? One of my favorite moments still.
좀 더 눈을 감고 귀를 닫고 내 안에 있는 나를 좀 더 차단해서 끄집어내고 이런 일들 좀 더 힘쓰고 그냥 나는 나의 길을 간다는 생각으로 해야 될 것 같다고.
What's with him?
Under the sea.
Of course, you gotta take it to photosynthesis. Everybody's just talking about the sun. I'm like. Okay. He's made that decision, he's running with it. Bye, Jin. Your office is gonna be so big, you don't even know. Birthday party. Uh-oh.
Hey, what's up, man?
Oh my god.
What in jail?
Oh my god, that's gonna make me nervous. Just as bad. No, stop all that.
제가 총을 좀 워낙 좀 지금 기강하게 추거든요.
내가 저기
생겼냐? 최근 들어 제 게 하나 없어졌어요. 그 제가 입고 있는 것 같아요.
Stop.
태양이에요.
All right, I haven't actually heard that song yet. I think it's on my list of things coming up. All right, Penelope. Penelope came in right when the credits started going. Like, how does she know? She was laying over there. The music started. She's like, oh, must be done. Must be over. All right, everyone. That was chapter 4 of The Rise of Bangtan. I really, really enjoyed that. Like I said, I love seeing all these moments. Sometimes they're hard to see. Like when RM went meet all of his old friends. Like, I knew it happened. I never watched it unfold like that. And I don't think I want to see the rest because I want to punch them in the face and just have this big poster that says United Nations ambassador and speaker and just hold it in front of them like this. And anytime they try to talk, I'd be like, you know? See, this is why I don't do that. Anyway, okay, I hope that you enjoyed it. Like I said, I'll be back with more behind the scenes and deleted scenes later on. I'll probably go 5 and 6 next and then do like a compilation of the deleted scenes again. But I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you again so much to this army that put it all together. Thank you again so much to my patrons for all of your support, especially Kirsten, Brie, and Kaylight. You guys are amazing. And if you like this, make sure you click like, comment, and subscribe. I'll be back with more videos soon, but until then, bye. Love to know them by name. So